Okay, good morning. Today's class we are going to know about the dynamic programming. So this is also one type of designing technique for the algorithms. So this is also one designing technique for algorithms. And here dynamic programming mainly depends upon the principle of optimality. Already we know a little bit about the greedy method, and dynamic programming and greedy method both are suitable for the optimization problems. So already you know what is the optimization problem, the feasible solution with the objective function when minimizes or maximizes the objective function with the feasible solution, that we can call as the optimization solution. Already last class we learned about that. So here greedy method and dynamic programming both can be useful for to solve the optimization type of problems. So in this anyway greedy method will uses the one type of decision. Dynamic programming generally it uses the principle of optimality to solve the problems. It uses the principle of optimality. So what is principle of optimality means the problem can be solved by taking the sequence of decisions to get the optimal solution. So already you know about the feasible solution and optimal solution. Feasible solution is the possible solution which will satisfies the constraints of the problem, and also it is using only the subset of inputs, not the complete inputs. If it is using the subset of inputs and satisfying the constraints of the problems, then we can call it as a feasible solution. And what is the optimization solution is it is the one feasible solution which maximizes or minimizes of the objective function, that we can call as the optimized solution or optimal solution. Here to solve the optimization type of problems in dynamic programming, it uses the principle of optimality. What is the principle of optimality means problem can be solved by taking the sequence of decisions every time to get the optimal decision, to get the optimal solution. That we can call as the principle of optimality. So before continuing with the dynamic programming, now I am just giving the information related to what are the differences between the greedy method and dynamic programming, because already we know little bit about the greedy method. One application also covered with the greedy method in yesterday class. So in greedy method also we will take the decisions to get the optimal solution, but in greedy method we will take one decision at the time and we will follow that decision to get the optimization problems. It may be the either a minimum or maximum of objective function. And here in greedy method we said we will try to take the one decision and we need to follow. That's why greedy method is try to follow the predefined method. We can say greedy method is following the predefined procedure. To get the optimal solution, whereas dynamic method, dynamic programming tried all the feasible solutions. With the dynamic programming, it tries all the possible solutions. Within that, what are the feasible solutions are there? What are the feasible solutions are there? Within that, it will check what are the feasible solutions are there. Within that, it will pick the optimal solution. It will pick the optimal. It picks the optimal solution. So, in greedy method, we'll take the one decision. That means we are following that decision. Means it is following the predefined procedure. Whereas in dynamic programming, it takes every time some decisions, and in this dynamic programming, by using the dynamic programming, we will find all the possible solutions within that, which are the feasible solutions are there. Within that feasible solutions, according to the objective maximization or minimization, within that we will take the one optimal solution. So here we are finding all the possible solutions and finding the feasible solutions. That's why dynamic programming is time consuming than the greedy program. Dynamic programming is time consuming than the greedy method of type of algorithm technique. And here mainly in dynamic programming, it uses recursive formulas and also iteration method to solve the problems. In dynamic programming, it uses recursive formulas and also iterative methods. Dynamic programming type of designing technique, it uses recursive formulas and iterative methods to solve the problems. And in greedy method, I already told you, we will take the one time decision and we'll follow that decision. And whereas in dynamic programming, in every stage we'll take the decisions. And we'll continue with that one. And for this also, to get this dynamic programming type of approach to solve the problems, it uses the two methods: memorization method, tabulation method. Memorization method and tabulation method. It uses two types of methods to solve the dynamic type of programming: memorization and iteration type. Whereas in memorization, it uses the recursive type of formulas and recursive type of functions to solve that problem with the memorization technique or memorization method. Whereas we are going for the tabulation, it uses iterative method. And maximum times, dynamic programming uses the tabulation type of method. Instead of memorization, it uses tabulation type of method. And to understand easily and to understand better what is memorization and what is tabulation, and maximum times I told you dynamic programming will go with the tabulation type of method only. To understand it better, I'll give you one example. Before going to that, once again I'm repeating this one. Dynamic programming is also one type of designing technique, algorithm designing technique, and it uses the principle of optimality. What is principle of optimality means? Problem can be solved by taking the sequence of decisions to get the optimal solution. And for any problem, whatever may be the solutions are there, different type of solutions, that we can call as all possible solutions. If any constraints are there in the problem, if it is satisfying that constraints, then that type of solution we can call as a feasible solution. And any feasible solution, and also one more point is there with the feasible solution, it is not using all the inputs. It can be, or it may be used. That means if it requires, it can use all the inputs, or if it is not required, it can use the subset of inputs to get the feasible solution. And what is optimal solution, where we can apply the principle of optimality to get this one, means optimal solution means the feasible solution which maximizes or minimizes according to the requirement of problem, that we can call as the optimal solution. So dynamic programming as well as a greedy method type of programming, greedy method type of designing techniques are also useful for get the optimal type of solutions for the problems. So it mainly uses the principle of optimality, and main some differences are there with the dynamic programming and greedy method. Greedy method generally uses the predefined procedure, and dynamic programming, it uses dynamically, it will take the decisions at every step and it continue to get the optimal solutions. And also in dynamic programming, greedy method, generally we are going to get the only the one optimal solution, that way by the predefined procedure, whatever the decision taken, depending upon that, we will get the one optimal solution. And by the dynamic programming, in this procedure, we will find all the possible solutions within that. If it is satisfying the constraints, that we can consider as a feasible solutions. Within the feasible solution, we are picking up the optimal solution. By taking the every time decisions dynamically. That's why it is called as a dynamic. And instead of one solution, here we are trying to get all the possible, within that only we are picking up. That's why it is a time consuming one. Dynamic programming is time consuming one. And to get that optimal solution by using the dynamic programming, it uses the two methods, recursive formulas, it can be used, and iterative what we can say functions or loops or iterative methods, it can be used. And these two, wherever we are using these two type of formulas and methods, is in memorization method and in tabulation method. Memorization method is one type of method where we can use the recursive formulas. Name itself says whatever the solutions or step-by-step solutions we are getting, that we are storing into the one place and we are memorizing every time to that previous solutions to get the new solution, to get the new solution. And tabulation method means every time whatever the sub problem solutions are there, that we are storing into the, that we are storing into one table, and we are by using that information, tabular information, we are going forward and we are moving to the next step to get the optimal solution, to get the optimal solution. That's why we said memorization method uses the recursive formulas. Tabulation method generally uses iterative. Both are useful only, but maximum times dynamic programming prefers to use the tabulation type of method to solve the problems. Till this point, it is clear, I think. Yes. So, you understand what is memorization, what is tabulation method, and why it is preferring more tabulation method, and how dynamic programming continuing with the tabulation method, that we can continue with the one example. So that is I am going to give you one example. If anyone want to just note down this theme points, so what are the points shown? Principle of optimality, predefined procedure, one time decision. But this greedy method, one time decision, we are making the decisions at every step. Every step. Here we are finding all possible, feasible within that, picking up one optimal solution. And two methods are there, memorization and tabulation. For memorization, it uses the recursive, for tabulation, it uses the iterative. And maximum times it uses the tabulation method. So this is about the simple information related to the dynamic programming. So to the next one, look at the simple example. What is memorization and what is tabulation? To understand that, what I am taking the example is Fibonacci series. Fibonacci series of numbers. So, what is Fibonacci series? Already you know, but just I am revising that point. That is, for every next number, it is adding the previous two numbers. So I am starting from the zero. Next, I am adding previous, only one number is available. So I am next continuing with the one. First Fibonacci series will start from this. By adding these two, I will get the next number one. By adding these two, I will get the next number two. By adding these two, next number, I will get the five. By adding these two, I am getting the next number five. Next, by adding these two, I will get the 13. Next number is by adding this, like this. This is the Fibonacci series. This is the Fibonacci series. So to find that particular number, till the particular number, what is the Fibonacci series? What is the Fibonacci series? That is, I am taking the here example. So for example purpose, I just, what is the condition for this is, till it is 0 or 1. If I am taking the n as 0 or 1, if n is equal to 0, what is the Fibonacci series? We will get only the 1. If I am taking n is equal to 1, what is the Fibonacci series I will get? 0 and 1. That's it. 1 only. If more than that, if I am considering Fibonacci series, what I will get? So I want to get the fourth number in the Fibonacci series, means by adding the previous two numbers, I'll get the next number if n is greater than 1. So what is the simple notation for the Fibonacci series? Is this one is the notation. So for the, I said two methods are there by using the memorization method. If I'm considering the memorization type of method, what is the simple logic for this is, if I want to find the nth number Fibonacci series, I'll go if n is less than or equals to 1, then return the n. That's what I said here, right? If n is equal to 0, it returns 0. If n is equal to 1, it returns 1. If more than that only, then I am going for the recursive formulas. What is the recursive formulas? It is going to use this recursive formula like this to get the next figure of the number. So if I want to, for the memorization method, I think no need of detailed explanation for this Fibonacci series and what are the number of Fibonacci series. If n is equal to 0, this one, if n is equal to 1, this one. How we are getting the, if n is equal to more than 1, that already we revised that one by adding the previous two numbers. That's what we wrote here. If n is equal to third means we need to first go for the what is 3 minus 2 and what is 3 minus 1, previous two terms. So if for example purpose, I'm taking the Fibonacci series of fifth number. I want to know that one. Then what is the, if n is equal to more than 1 means if n is equal to less than or equals to 1, it returns 1. Otherwise, it returns what it is? Previous two terms. What is the previous term? 5 minus 2 is Fibonacci of 2. What is the 5 minus 1? Fibonacci of 4. Till now, I don't know what is the Fibonacci of 3 and Fibonacci of 4. So, for this Fibonacci, to find this Fibonacci 3, what is the, now it becomes as a n is equal to 3 here. Here n is equal to 5. What is the previous two terms? These two. If n is equal to 3 means n minus 2 implies n minus 1 I want to add that 2. By adding these two, I will get this. To get this information, again I am calling this one. Now I am considering n is equal to 3. Now also it is more than 1. Then I am going for this. So now what information I want? N minus 3 means 3 minus 2. First I want the frequency of 1. And 3 minus 1, what is the Fibonacci of 2? I want the information. Once again, I want to check this. Fibonacci of 1 means if n is equal to 1, what it returns? It returns same thing, 1. So I know this value now. And what is the Fibonacci of 2? It is already more than 1. Then again, I need to go for this recursive function. I need to call this recursive function. What it is now, it is becoming n is equal to 2. What n minus 2 means? Fib of 0 and fib of 1. I need to call. So if n is equal to 0 means what it is? It returns same thing. If n is equal to 1 means it returns the value 1. So now already I know. To get the information, what I need to do? Add these two. To get this information, I need to add this information and this information. So what is the value of Fibonacci 2? Here 1. What is the Fibonacci 1? 1 plus 1. What is the Fibonacci of the 2 value? And now I need to get this one. So again it is becoming n is equal to 4. So to know this Fibonacci of 4, I am calling the recursive function here. That means it calls n minus 2. 4 minus 2 means here it needs to call 4 minus 2, Fibonacci of 2. Again, what is n minus 1? Fib of 2. Again it will become n is equal to 3 here, n is equal to 4 here. Again, it needs to call a fib of 0, fib of 1. Okay. Again, for this, it calls that fib of 1 and fib of 0, fib of 2. Again, fib of 2 to find that information, it needs to call this. And instead of every time, this is repeating here, here and here. If I am every time I am calculating, it is taking 2 to the power of n times of time. Every time, whenever calculating this one, it will take 2 to the power of n times. Instead of that, according to the memorization method, what I am doing is whatever the values I am getting, that I am storing into the my array, I am reusing that one. Instead of finding two or three more times, here I need to find fib of 1, 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 like that. Instead of doing same, fib of 2 also, here I am need to find, here I need to find, here I need to find fib of 2, fib of 3 also, here I am finding, here I am finding. Instead of doing the same procedure repeatedly and wasting of time, that's why to not waste the time, I am going for the memorization method. In this memorization method, what I am doing, I am storing into the array values. Whatever the values I am getting, I am storing into the array. So array index I am taking here, this one. So what I need to get, I want to get the information about fib of 5. So I am storing the array values like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. At the starting, what I am doing here, every information is storing minus. So an array, every element at the index of 0, at the index of 1, at the index of 2, at the index of 3, at the index of 4, at the index of 5, I am storing with the minus and minus. Whenever I am doing this type of recursive functions, I am calling all these functions. Whenever I got this information, I am replacing this one. First, I calculated this type of fib of 3. Within that, I calculated fib of 1. So, fib of 1, what I got? Value 1. Where fib of 1, I am replacing the value with this and storing this. And next, I got the fib of 0. Fib of 0, already I got the value information. So, whenever I want to calculate once again here, I am using this store value. Here, how we got? By adding these and these values, I got the fib of 3 also 2. So I am replacing this one with the 2. So by this left part, I got the 3 values. Whenever the fib of 1 is equal to 1, that I stored instead of minus 1. Whenever I got the value fib of 0, that is a 0 that I stored into the value. Whenever I got the value fib of 2, fib of 2 by adding these two, I got the value 1, then I replaced 1. And whenever I got the value for this fib of 3 by adding these two, instead of calculating all this, so I can check for this fib of 1 plus fib of 2. Fib of 1 already 1 is there, fib of 2 already 1 is there. By adding these two, I get the fib of 1. Here, now I want to know the value of fib of 2. Then fib of 4. What is the values I need to add according to this recursive formula means fib of 2 plus fib of 3. Instead of calculating once again all these things, I simply use the values which are stored in my array. What is the value of fib of 2 here? 1. What is the value of fib of 3 here? 2. So 1 plus 2, by adding these two, I will get the fourth value. So that I am replacing here with the value. Fib of 2 value is 1, fib of 3 value is 2, so I am replacing the value with 2. So if I want to know the value of this fib of 5, instead of doing once again all these things, simply by using the my stored information, what is the fib of 3 value? 2. What is the fib of 4 value? 4. By adding these two, I will get the value and store some. If I want to know the fib of 6, after all this, already I know the information I stored into the array. After all this, if n value is equal to 6, what I will do instead of writing all these things, simply according to the recursive formula, what is required? N value, fib of 4. Instead of n value coming, fib of 4, n value is equal to 6. Means if I want to find fib of 6 value, then I will call the recursive function. N is equal to 6, 6 minus 2. Next, n minus 1, 6 minus 1 means I need to get the value of fib of 4. Now, by adding all these two, I will get the fib of 6. Instead of again calling the recursive formulas and finding that, by using the my stored array, by memorizing that my values which are already stored in this array, by using these values, fib of 4 already I know 3, fib of 5 already I know that is 5. Now, what is the value for this? Fib of 6 is 5. Now I can store in the array next. So this is the method for the memorization. Instead of 2 power n times CPU calling and once again repeating that one, 1 or 2 steps, 1 or 2 steps, or 1 less than that number of steps. How many number of this one is there? That many plus 1. Within the n plus 1 steps, we will get the solution. This is about the memorization method to get the solution with the dynamic programming to get the solution for one problem with the memorization. What is memorization method means? It uses array to store the information. It uses the array to store the information and it reuses whatever the information stored in the array, it reuses to get the next step of the problem, to get the solution for the next step of the problem. It uses already stored in previous steps information. So to store that information, what it is using? Simple. This type of method we can call as a memorization method. Memorization method. So this is the thing. Is this clear? This is the one method, memorization method. Another method to solve the dynamic programming is tabulation method. Tabulation method. So now I am going to use the table method. Instead of array, here I am using one table. I am taking the same example, Fibonacci series only. Instead of memorization, I am going for the tabulation method. In tabulation method, it uses iterative methods. Instead of recursive formulas, recursive functions, it uses iterative methods. For iteration, there are two loops are there. For loop, while loop, do while loop in programming languages. Generally, for the iteration purpose, it uses that loops. So, next method is tabulation method, which is generally used to solve the optimization problems by using the dynamic programming type of approach. So, now I am going for the tabulation. Same example I am taking. We call the tabulation type of method. Thing is same here. For it enable to run, we can perform certain things. We go n minus 1 with n is 1. Same Fibonacci series I'm using. Here instead of array, I'll use the table. And what is the code for this? This is the iterative method. This is where I'm working. So this is where that is. Just note on that, we will go for the table method. Same thing for the Fibonacci series only. This is the simple logic for the Fibonacci series by using the iterative method. It is not specified anywhere here, no? Iterative method. So by using this logic only, what it is there by using the table method is whenever f of 0 is equal, what is the value? 0. I store into the, whenever I value is equal less than or equals to, or n value is equal less than or equals to, otherwise we can say directly f of 0 is equal to, f of 0 is equal to what is the value? 0. I am storing into the table. F of 1 is equal to what is the value? 1. I am storing into the directory table. Now I will start from the I value from the 2. So in this table I am taking the i value from the 2. Whenever I is equal to 2, what I need to get? Whenever the I is equal to 2, what it will do? Whenever I is equal to 2, 2 minus 2 means 2 minus 1. 2 minus 2 here, 2 minus 1. What is here? F of 0 plus F of 1. What is the F of 0 value here? 0. F of 1 value? 1. So 0 plus 1, what I will get? Once again, 1. So whenever I value here incremented according to this law, it will become as now 3. Whenever I value is incremented from 2, now I value become as, I value become as 3. So it will, again what it is here, I value is equal to 2 means here 3 minus 2, 3 minus 2. So f of 2 plus f of 1 plus f of. So what is f of 1 in the table? 1. F of 2 value in the table? 1. 1 plus 1? 2. So here whenever the I value is incrementing from this point to this point, simply by adding these two will be. I value is incremented from this point to this, by adding these two will be. If I want to the 6th one, I value is equal to 6, by adding these two I'll go. It can continue. This is the tabulation, and generally it uses this type of solution. This is about the dynamic programming, and in next class we are going to know about the dynamic programming, one more application, NAPSOP application. Before going to that, whatever the NAPSOP application I gave you with the greedy method, just go through that one. And next we are going to know about the dynamic programming. What is the application? First application is NAPSOP application only, NAPSOP problem only, but name little bit changes, 01 NAPSOP. And this is the information related to the dynamic programming. Today I am closing this by this topic only, because NAPSOP problem will take at least 40 to 50 minutes. That I will continue with the next class. So any one of you gave CRs, attendance mark.